This video shows how EMPro can be used for EMI and EMC analysis of a PC board design inside a metal chassis. We'll start with EMC analysis, which measures the susceptibility of designs to electromagnetic energy from outside noise sources. We will create a plane wave excitation that is initiated outside the chassis, then measure how much energy from this plane reaches a rectangular power plane on the PCB inside the chassis. In EMPro, we create a new plane wave excitation, set the incident angles for phi and theta, and select the polarization. Next, we set up a port and near-field sensor on the power plane so we can collect received noise voltage and E-field levels versus frequency. Finally, we run a time domain simulation using the FDTD solver in EMPro. Here are the results, showing the voltage levels at frequencies up to 12 GHz. The two plots represent two different plane wave excitations at different incident angles. We can see peaks at various frequencies due to the resonances in the chassis structure. Here are similar results when we switch the polarization type. We can also visualize the E-fields at different cuts of the 3D geometry. This animation shows a transient E-field plot using plane wave excitation. Here is a steady state E-field plot at 2.15 GHz. Using the same design example, let's look at EMI analysis, which measures electromagnetic emissions from a design, which may interfere with nearby electronic systems. We've created a differential pair on the PCB design that we will drive with differential and common signals and compare the emissions. In EMPro, we can create a custom waveform using voltage versus time data in CSV format. Here's the waveform we will use as the excitation in this example, shown in both the time and frequency domains. EMPro includes an EMI Emissions Calculation tool that computes emissions levels from the results of a previous EM simulation. In this tool, we select which simulation data we want to use, then we can select the custom waveform we just created as the excitation. We'll use the same waveform for both ports of the differential line, but switch the amplitude multiplier on one port between +1 and -1 to switch between common and differential mode excitation. Then we set the distance at which we want to calculate the emissions levels, in this case 3 meters. Here are the results. This plot shows the E-field strength at frequencies up to 7 GHz. The red points represent common mode excitation, and as expected, produce higher emissions than differential mode excitation, shown in blue. We can also overlay a specification limit on the plotted results, so we can see how the calculated emissions compare to FCC, CISPR, and other standards. In this case, we are showing the FCC Class B standard. In order to simulate the effects of discontinuities in the PCB ground plane, we've added a slot that runs under the differential pair. Now we simply recalculate the emissions and view the results. Here we can see the addition of the slot has increased emissions levels, both for common mode excitation, shown in green, and differential mode excitation, shown in blue. In this example, we've shown how EMPro can be used to analyze EMC susceptibility based on an incoming plane wave excitation, as well as quickly calculate EMI emissions and compare the results to industry standard EMI limit specifications. For more information on Agilent's integrated 3D EM solutions, please visit agilent.com and request a free trial.